Hello guys, welcome to part 9. In the last part we got to these mysterious stairs by a place where you can heal and save, so that tells me there's a boss battle up here. And judging by the past evidence, it might be Miror B. Wait, there's a kid here? Shit. Grr. I guess I'm not fighting Miror B yet. I guess that was just kind of like a checkpoint. Oh boy. Well, hopefully we'll end up fighting some bosses. Oh my god! Lotad and Lombre. Well, at least they spiced it up a bit with the Lombre. Yeah, there's definitely something fishy about all of these Lotads and friends. Let's go for Lombre first, because we've learned that Lotad is not a threat. Oh well, Lombre is actually pretty good. Lombre and Hyper Mode. That's okay. Lombre and Ludicolo are actually pretty good Pokemon. I use a Ludicolo on my Rain Dance teams all the time. Astonish. Oh no, that was super effective. And I don't mind if he's going Hyper Mode. He's better to go in Hyper Mode now than in a boss battle. I've said that many, many times. So, yeah. I'm thinking maybe I should start talking about unrelated things while I'm doing battles that are pointless, you know, like this one. But I have no idea what to talk about. I know a lot of LPers just start rambling about things that are unrelated. I can never think of anything to talk about, though. So, yeah. Ooh, Metatailor and Confusion! Sweet! Let's use that. Double Confusion Attack! That'd be cool if both your Pokemon and all that knew the same attack, they can, like, combine. That would be cool, but whatever. Yay, we won! We're the wieners, do-do-do-do. I made them faint. What does it look like I did? Okay, you know, since... Is Miror B's age really going to... What? I don't know what that's supposed to mean. Okay, I'm gonna go up this way very slowly. Yes, I know I'm running good. Okay, this dark corridor... Okay, there's another trainer. It's not Miror B yet. There's another trainer that way? Wow, maybe I have a while before him. Darn it. And didn't we meet a guy who was just saying that same thing earlier? And he looked like that, too. Swablu. And guess who? Lotad. Okay, this is really getting on my nerves. What? Swablu! That's the Swablu you can catch! Huh, I know what I'm doing this battle. Alright, Metatite, you are gonna use Confusion on Swablu. Espeon, you are gonna use Confusion on Lotad, because I wanna kill Lotad. I do wanna catch Swablu. Haha, critical hit. Not that I needed it. Lotad wouldn't have done hardly any damage to me anyway. Beldum? Wow. At least it's something original. Oh, Metatite. Oh, Metatite. What am I gonna do with you? I know you have crappy special attack, but I didn't think it was that bad. Alright. Metatite, instead use Shadow Rush on Swablu. I don't think you'll kill him. If you do... Wait a minute. Nothing is... Okay, sorry. Metatite, you're gonna have to attack Beldum, because nothing is good against him. Espeon, you use Return on Swablu. Yes, that didn't kill him. Alright. We're gonna use some balls on her. And I knew it was gonna be Hyper Mode! Fly? That's interesting. I guess I can't hit Swablu this turn. That's okay. We'll go for Beldum. And Metatite's in Hyper Mode. What a shock. Metatite, I'm gonna call you. And Espeon. I don't know what to do with you. You can't really do anything this turn. Oh, I guess you can reflect. That sounds good. Because I bet Swablu's using Fly on Metatite because it's super effective. So, this is a purely defensive turn. Because Metatite couldn't do anything due to his hyper mode. And Espeon's using Reflect. I was hoping he would hit himself in the sky. He didn't even use it on Metatite. Wow. Wow, they're going for Espeon. Oh, okay. They were going for Espeon, but now they changed their mind at the last second. That's why they never end up killing my guys. They always go for both at the same time. If they maybe slowed down a little bit and went for one at a time. Okay, we're going to use a ball on Swablu. Let's start with a great ball. I don't think I'm ever going to use my Pokeballs ever again. Because we're getting into harder to catch Pokemon now. And yeah, I don't know if I'm going to use Swablu or not. I just kind of want him. Woohoo! I caught Swablu! Yay! And Lombre! And Hyper Mode. I should have guessed. You know, I have a feeling Espeon is actually going to faint for once in a battle. Has he fainted yet this entire LP? I don't know. I don't think he has. No, wait! Metatite, I have to call you. Sorry. Espeon, you've already reflected, so confusion on Lombre. Well, Metatite, the sooner we get your Shadow Bar down, the sooner I guess we can train Swablu. I don't know if I'm going to use Swablu forever, but... yeah. Whatever. Water Gun. Oh, no. Yeah, this is really boring. Metatite, let's try again! How many times? That was three times in a row, I think he's gone into hyper mode. Bye, Lombre. Alright, Metatite, yay! You didn't go into hyper mode! Good job! Nice! Critical hit! Alright, good job, Metatite. That's how you play the game. Alright, I need to go heal. Good thing there's a healing place right over there. Your bright future! I'm sure you have a bright future. Especially if you work for Miror B. Everything's bright and shiny with him. I ruined your chances? Well, maybe you should have picked a better fight. I'll be back in a second. Okay, I've got done healing, and I put Swablu in my party, and I swapped out Umbreon, because like I said before, I'm actually not going to end up using Umbreon. Alright, so let's fight this guy now. I know you guys might be bored of just me fighting random trainers, but I'm sorry, I'd like to fight almost everyone I can find if I can. I want to get experience, because this game does get harder as it goes along. I know these battles have been easy for a while, but... okay, Pineco and Shuppet. High Jump Kick! Heck yeah, that's the move I've been waiting for. But... it won't hurt either of these guys very much. So you're going to use Confusion on Pineco, right? Pineco's pure bug, right? Yeah. This isn't a very good matchup, is it? Yeah, we're gonna use... both of you guys are gonna use Confusion on Pineco. Because I don't want him to explode. Because they have the chance of doing that. And I have a feeling that's why he started with Shuppet. Because if Pineco exploded, Shuppet wouldn't get hurt. Because he's the ghost type. Coughing! Ooh! Good thing I used Confusion on... that Pokemon. Because it was coughing and it's super effective. And the fact that it didn't kill him just proves how weak Metatite is, with special attack, that is. Foresight? That's basically an alternative version of Odor Sleuth. So basically, Shuppet just stood there this turn and did nothing. I'm fine with that. Espeon used Confusion on Shuppet, and Metatite used Confusion on Puffing. Bye, Shuppet. That was fun. Shuppet and Duskull, the two ghost Pokemon of the third generation, why'd they make Shuppet so bad? Duskull is so much better. And I just learned Psybeam! Hell yeah! Alright. Powers... okay. It's basically a better version of Confusion, except... It has a chance of confusing, so... why not? Yeah, I'm gonna get rid of Confusion. Bye, Confusion! Hello, Psybeam. Nice job, Espeon. I'm glad you know a better move than Confusion, because Confusion's like the worst psychic move out there. You deserved something better, and you got it. Metatite's probably gonna have Confusion all his life, because all psychic attacks in this game are special, and yeah, Metatite has crap special attack. This is ridiculous. Hey, you know what I just thought of? I still haven't looked at Metatite's nature. I should look at it right now. Watch, it's something really crappy. That is awesome! I actually got a Pokemon with an amazing nature. You know what Jolly is? Plus speed, minus special attack. So, Confusion's worse, and that explains even more why it's so weak. But that's okay, because he's meant for physical attacks. So, I am just fine with Jolly nature. There's stairs over here, too? Ugh, which stairs should I go down? The other one looked like less conspicuous. That's the right word, right? I'll go to that one. Because it does want you to go in these in a certain order. At least that's how games are designed. Let's see what's in this one. It looks like that exact same place I was, except without the healer place. And where the heck is this? A dark, spooky cave? Oh my god, that's Miror B in there. Am I healed? Yes, I'm fully healed. Alright guys, I think we're gonna fight Miror B now. And he has 4 Ludicolos. That explains why so many people have Lotads and Lombres, because Miror B loves Ludicolos. Alright, here we go guys. It's about time, darlings. I'm so frightfully tired of waiting for you. Stop the music. Oh, you kept me waiting for that. I just had to work up a little perspiration. Foo-ho-ho-ho. But why have you been naughty and messing up our plans? It was oh so close for everything to turn out just right, just the way we had hoped. I can salvage our plan by beating you, little man. And so there's time for one last frantic dance before the grand finale. Let the music play. Da-na-na-na-na-na. Our first real boss battle. Miror B. 2 Ludicolos. Alright. Now, I don't know if you can tell this already, but Miror B's strategy is using Rain Dance, basically. Some of his Ludicolos have Swift Swim, some have Rain Dish. Either way, they're pretty strong, because they use water attacks, and yeah. So, we're going to start off by, let's see. Metatite, you're going to use High Jump Kick. I know it's risky, but because if it misses, he gets hurt. They're both going to attack the higher level Ludicolo. And there's no point in using Reflect, because all of Ludicolo's attacks will be special, because grass and water are both special attacks. Well, let's see how your first Psybeam does. Nice job, Espeon. High Jump Kick. Let's see how good this does. Bam! Nice job, Metatite. That is why I wanted Metatite on my team. He is amazing. One Ludicolo down already. And there's his other one. Alright, what's his Ludicolo? Oh, of course, Rain Dance. Should have guessed that. Alright, now I don't know which one has Swift Swim and which has Rain Dance, but I'd like to kill the Swift Swim ones first, because they can go before me. Let's just go for the level 30. Let's just go for whichever one's higher leveled at the time. Just, you know. Don't know why, but I don't think either of them have Swift Swim, because they didn't. Espeon still went first. But wait, that one went before Metatite. Okay, the level 29 has Swift Swim. And that's gonna make Metatite flinch, isn't it? Oh, it didn't! Nice job, Metatite. Except you missed. You just would miss, wouldn't you? Oh yeah, Ludicolos aren't gonna use any physical moves. Wonderful, Metatite's dead. Alright. Great. Let's you. Okay, clearly they're not just sticking to those types of moves, so... Let's see. Let's use Flappy. Why? Because he's going to paralyze people, so it doesn't matter if they have Swift Swim or not. Alright. Yes, that one has Rain Dish. Okay. Flappy, you... Thunder Wave, the level 20... Wait a minute. Actually, the level 30 isn't going to die this turn. Because he healed a little bit. Both of you need to attack at level 30. And Espeon, I'm sorry, but you can't afford to use Reflect right now because you are the main attacker of this team. By far. Absorb? There's a special attack, but... Absorb? My Skiploom knows a better version of that attack. That's just sad. And he went for Espeon. Look at them trying to kill Espeon, it's hilarious. Oh, they're going. That one's going for Flaffy. And if I'm lucky, the static will paralyze him. I won't need to paralyze him myself. Ha ha ha. Not that it matters, because that one's going to die now. But, oh well. It's still fun to paralyze things. Alright, nice job, guys. Another Ludicolo is down. Another Ludicolo! What level is that? My screen is small because I'm recording it on my computer. I can't see what level that is. It's either an 8 or a 6. Yeah, it looks like an 8. Either way, it's lower than the 29, so let's go for the 29. Flaffy? I know the 29 has Swift Swim. I want you to Thunder Wave it. And Espeon's going to Psybeam it. And hopefully that will do more than half. Yes, it does. So now Espeon will kill him next turn. Astonish is going to hit Flaffy, and Flaffy's going to flinch, right? Oh my god, another one's using Astonish. Yeah, two Astonishes are definitely going to make him flinch. Yeah. That's okay, it hardly did any damage, so... You gotta look at this as damage ratio, so... We're going to use Thunder Wave on that one. Espeon, you're going to use Psybeam and finish this one off. Because even in the rain, you're faster than them. Nice job. Sudowoodo! Something different! And that is a shadow Pokemon. Should I try to catch Sudowoodo? Razor Leaf? For a second I was thinking that was a physical attack, because it isn't nowadays, but no, it's a special attack in the old days. So. Alright, Thunder Wave. So wait, he has one Ludicolo left, and then the Sudowoodo. I'm going to try to catch Sudowoodo. Just because. I'm probably not going to use it, but I just want it. Because you do fight Miror B again in the future, and if you haven't caught Sudowoodo, he'll have him again. I don't know if he'll replace him with someone else if I catch him, but yeah, that's the way it goes. You're going to Thunder Wave Sudowoodo. Espeon, you're going to Psybeam that Ludicolo. Alright, you guys are doing amazing. Nice job. Yeah, that's how you do it. And Thunder Wave. And see, that other Ludicolo didn't go before me, because he was slower now. So, that is a good thing indeed. Low Kick. Well, Espeon's not that heavy, and Low Kick is a fighting move, so... Oh, the rain stopped! Maybe that's why he wasn't faster. Oh well. Good thing they didn't have Drizzle yet at this point. The only Pokemon that knew Drizzle at this point was Kyogre. Let's Thundershock Sudowoodo. I know it's not going to do very much, but that's the point. You're going to just finish off the Ludicolo. And then we basically beat Miror B, because... Looks to me like Sudowoodo is not going to be doing much damage. And Sudowoodo, he's a cool Pokemon, but... When it comes to rock types, he's not really good. I mean, I don't know what other rock types are available in this game, but... Either way, he's not the greatest. Yeah, and Thundershock did horrible, but not much else I can do. Let's try again. If Espeon, let's take the chance and use Psybeam. What's the worst that'll happen? He'll die. Who cares? I'm not gonna use him anyway. I just wanted to catch him to help me out in the future battle with Miror B. But then again, in the future battle with Miror B, I don't think Sudowoodo will have leveled up at all. So my Pokemon will be far higher leveled than 35. Okay, Shadow Rush. That, oh! Wow, that killed Flaffy. Okay, if Sudowoodo uses that again, I'm dead. So, I mean, no, he's dead if he uses Shadow Rush again, because he'll die from recoil. So, let's use Croconaw, I guess. I don't know. Yes, your bow is weak, Croconaw. Alright, with Croconaw, I think Sudowoodo is hard to catch, so I'm going to start with an Ultra Ball. Croconaw, you are going to start... Oh, you're going to... I'm going to use the ball with you. Let's start with Ultra Ball on the Sudo. And Espeon, you're going to use Reflect just for the possibility of... just to lower the chances of Sudowoodo killing himself with Shadow Rush. Because he won't do as much damage to himself if he doesn't do as much damage to me. And... it didn't matter because I caught him! Heck yeah, I got a Sudowoodo. Not that I'm going to use him, but... I defeated Cypher Admin Miror B. I can't keep up with the tempo. Oh no no, what a no no! Ha ha. That is it, we defeated Miror B. Mwahahaha. How dare you? Don't you dare think you'll get away with your latest outrage. One of these days I will take great pleasure in kicking you about with my elegant dance steps. Oh, and I'm not giving up our Shadow Pokemon plan. Let's go, escape! Oh boy. Kyun Kyun? What's Kyun Kun? Must be a plus. Oh! Oh! Oh, yeah, I forgot we were here. We were rescuing Plusle. And what did we win? We won a TM49. Let's see what that. Let's see what that is. Snatch! They're thinking of the worst TMs to be giving me, but that's okay. It's Plusle! Yay! We caught Plusle. We rescued Plusle. What the heck? How did they get here? What? Really? Miror B got away, but things will be back here, will be back to normal. I don't know what to say. Forget it, Silva. We're all in here, unharmed. That's good enough. Even that Miror B's been driven out, thanks to AB11. What's that, Plusle? Feeling hungry out of relief? Wahahaha. Let's quit, leave the moldy cavern. Oh, I didn't finish exploring it, though. Arr. Alright, well, they're all super duper happy and stuff. Plusle wants to come with us? Oh, that's right! I forgot. Yeah, we get Plusle now. One of the only Pokemon in this game that you get that is not a Shadow Pokemon. The only ones are Espeon, Umbreon, Plusle, and Ho-Oh, if you end up catching and purifying every Shadow Pokemon of the game. But... I already have a Ho-Oh in my main game, so I don't feel like getting it in this game. Because you can't even get it until you've beaten the main game, and I'm not playing anything more than the main game. A PDA number? I guess I don't have cell phones in this world, and everyone has a PDA. Alright, how much time do I have? Oh, it's getting pretty long. I guess that's a good place to end it. I just beat Miror B. Yeah, I'm going to go back to the cavern in between this and the next part and see if there's anything worth showing there. And if there is, I'll record it, but if not, then I won't. So that's all for this part. I hope you enjoyed it, and I certainly did because we actually had a boss battle. And he was somewhat challenging because he killed a Metatitan Floffy. That's better than most trainers have done. So yeah, see you all next time, and rock on!